Ryan. We get a word with Ryan King. What a race you had tonight. I mean, you were coming from back in the pack, passed these guys pretty quick, got up there in the lead, and you just didn't look back. Tell me about the car.
Well, the car was fast tonight. Like I said, out here last week, started seventh and come up through there last week, and then this week was able to get up front and stay out there. I mean, we just had a good car. I mean, you know, it was quickest all night long, and this Warrior car has been really good, and this is only the second race I drove this car, and I think it's going to be a really good car for the rest of the season, and I'm looking forward to working with these guys the rest of the year with this car.
And what a good first place finish on our Walter Ball Memorial Night. You know, as we honor Walter tonight, a racing legend. How was the track here at Volunteer Speedway for you?
Hey, again, just like last week, track was great. I mean, there was multiple grooves to run out there. I kind of had to hunt around a little bit. I tried up high a couple laps, and I jumped back down. Then I changed my mind again and get back up there. So, I mean, I know the race was probably pretty good behind me because I could move around, and I was still hunting grooves even though I was out there in the lead just figuring out what was going on behind me.
Who would you like to thank on the car?
Well, Warrior race cars. Like I said, new race car. We put this thing together at Warrior. Mike Knuckles has been here at the racetrack helping me. We've been tuning on this thing, been doing a lot of research, a lot of work in the shop, and it's finally paying off. Got to thank my dad. You know, he pays for this stuff for me. I mean, biggest supporter there financially. A lot of my sponsors, you know, Phantom Race Engines. Got to thank some of these. HVH, Parton's Barbecue, Day Gutters and Siding. I mean, all my sponsors. I mean, they all really helped me a lot. And
fantastic. Good first place finish. Y'all give him that big round of applause. Driving his number 30, Ryan King. Man, that was one of the most exciting battles right there that we've seen in a little while. You battling out with Greg for that second place finish. Corey Hedgecock driving his 23. Tell me about the race.
Car was good. Just screwed up the start. Terrible. Just went in there and I didn't get a turn good enough and just drove right up across the racetrack in front of everybody. I think it would have been a different race if I'd have done that. But when I finally got by Greg and everything, I think we had as quick as cars, right? I don't know if we was any quicker or not, but I needed that caution and everything. And just all in all, he had a fast car the other night.
Do you think if you'd had just a few more laps that you might have caught him? Because you looked like after you got around distance, you had some pretty good momentum coming off the turns.
Yeah, it was. I don't know. It'd have been hard just because it was just kind of a real fast racetrack night, so it was going to be hard to pass on. But all in all, no, I think he had the faster car at the end of the night. You know, hats off to him. I think that's a new car, and they apparently did pretty good in it. But I'm happy with our stuff and everything. And we'll go somewhere tomorrow, I guess.
Fantastic. Who'd you like to thank on this car tonight?
Eagle Racing Engines, my mom, my dad, Bingham, my wife, ET Motor Gear, Renegade, K&P, Smith Built, Bruce Built. Everybody just keeps helping on this thing. It definitely makes, my week easier, week in, week out. So, you know, without them, I couldn't be here anyway. So, yeah.
Fantastic. Good, strong second place finish. Y'all give him a round robin. It's number 23, Corey Hedgecock. It's number 31, Mr. Greg Estes. Greg, that's a hard-fought finish right there, brother.
Yeah, it's my second race this year, and I'm still trying to get in that racing shape. And Ryan deserved it. I watched him last week, blew by me, and ran Jason Trammell down. So congrats to Ryan. Corey raced me real clean, and I'm glad to be able to get up here on the front stretch because these guys work so hard. Hunter and Vic Hill and Sean and Ricky and John, and I've got a lot of guys that put a lot of work into this thing.
Yeah, you seemed like you were doing a pretty good job blocking him. I mean, he was coming in on you pretty hard, and I know he tried to dip under you a couple times, and he started working on that high side, and he got you over there in turn two and made the pass coming down that back straightaway, and he was tough to grab after he got in front of you there.
He had a lot of traction coming off the corner. Anywhere I went, anywhere he went, he was just beating me off the corner. And I saw him up to my door on the inside, and we had that caution. My guys in the infield were saying, get down in one and two. So I got down in one and two, and I was spinning the tires, and I thought, well, I wonder how long it's going to be before I see him over here. Sure enough, there he comes.
Who all would you like to thank tonight, Greg?
Dick Hill, Race Engines. He does everything for me, and he's a great friend, and that whole organization is just super. Estes Brothers Construction, Pie Valley Bank, Boone's BP, but all my guys, everybody from Jonesville back in Virginia, they put a lot of work in this thing.
Well, you started second, you finished third. It was a good night for a good finish tonight. So congratulations, Greg, on the finish tonight.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Y'all give him a round of applause driving this number 31, Greg Estes. All right, our winner driving this number 24, Tim Bird. You just got out there and didn't look back, man.
Hey, we had an awesome car. The track conditions a little different than last week. It's my kind of track, blacker the better, you know. I want to thank my whole crew there and TNT Chassis and my family. Awful good TNT race cars down here at this track. But, yeah, I just want to thank Tri-City Moore and Sal and McCarty Performance and TNT race cars. And I want to thank my father for helping me all the time there, funding this deal. And this is a great night. This is my third Waller Ball Memorial.
Fantastic. That's awesome. You know, you had the second fastest qualifying time. Actually, and you know, you should have been on the outside, but then John Tweed elected to take the outside, and you seem to run pretty good on that inside line around this track.
Yeah, that's just what we want, you know, on them starts. That's what wins the race, is the whole start, you know. But, yeah, John had a quick car. I let up a little bit in qualifying there. It cost me a little time, but all in all, it's a good night.
Fantastic. Congratulations. Give him a big round of applause. Driving to number 24, Tim Bird.
Good job, Greg, and you see her.
I mean, it's number 68, Andy Ogle. Andy, what a race, brother. You had your hands full out there, but I tell you what, you finished good tonight, man.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it. It's a good racetrack. It's kind of all over the place out there, but it's kind of got to do what you got to do.
You know, we saw you riding in third place for a long time, and then you finally made a good move. You got around him. You got up there in second place. I know Tim Bird was kind of hard to catch, but you held your own once you got up there. But you had some strong competitors coming up on the backside.
Yeah, Tim's got a good race car. He's always fast up here, and I'm just glad to run second to him.
Who would you like to thank tonight, Andy?
I'd like to thank Steve McCarter Construction, Performance Chassis, and all the friends and family, and just everybody that made this possible.
How was the track tonight here at Speedway?
It's good. It's a little slick up top, but it's pretty good in the bottom.
Fantastic. Good enough to get you a good second place finish here tonight.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, y'all give it. Driving this number 68, Andy Ogle. Third place finisher. Not quite the result we had last week, but still a good finish tonight. Josh Henry in this B00. How was it tonight? You looked like you had a pretty good race on your hands there tonight.
Yeah, we had a really good race car. If we could just ever qualify, you know, and have a good starting spot, we might be able to win some more races. I really thought if we, you know, would have had one more caution, I'd like to see what we had for him. But to come from sixth to third, and if we just had one more caution, I'd like to see what we had.
Right. Well, you had a good strong finish. I mean, you finished up here in third place, but you brought some guys with you as you were coming up through the pack there pretty good. And it looked like it was a pretty good race right in the middle of that lead pack there for just the third and fourth spots.
Yeah, the five car and the 56 and the little number nine, I thought we put on a real good race. Yeah, I thought it was going to get a little sketchy coming off of two over here when 05 got sideways, but it all worked out, and I guess we'll try it again tomorrow.
Who would you like to thank tonight, Josh, on this car?
I got to thank my dad. Like I said, I wouldn't be here without him. My mom, Driscoll. Got to thank my wife, you know, for letting me race, working on these cars and get them ready, doing what I love to do. And my little girl, Haley, Jackie, Brent Hensley, Creed, Travis, Fluffy, Dick. If you've ever touched my papa sitting up here in the stands, I'm sure he's raring to go. Just thank everybody that's ever helped me.
Fantastic. Y'all give you a big round of applause. Good third place finish. Boo Henry in this 00. 2 weeks in a row. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. I'd like to thank Joe Lovin and them for racing the street stocks. I don't know, all these old street stock boys is mad at me because I built this car, but they put a set of rules out, and you build a car, then they whine and cry and bitch and gripe. I don't understand. I mean, you know, the 36 I run into me under caution, tried to knock my damn quarter panel up on my tar, I guess. But, I mean, you know, that's nonsense right there.
Well, who would you like to thank as far as the car goes here tonight?
Well, I'd like to thank everybody that helps me, my whole crew, my boy, Driscoll, Gary, Fluffy, my wife, my dad, the Dick, everybody, Steve Brady, Brent Hensley. Boy, it takes a lot of people to run a race team, even though if it's a street stock car. I drive a truck. I'm gone a lot. And if it wasn't for these people coming around doing what they need to do, and we just couldn't race.
Fantastic. And a good finish for Josh here tonight, too. Good third place finish.
Oh, yeah. I'm happy. You know, if you run the top three and And any race at Bulls Gap, you're doing good.
Fantastic. We give you a big round of applause on a win tonight. Taking the checkers home, number 25, Skip Henry. All right, folks, we're going to start with our second place finisher. Driving us number 36, Chris Rickett. Chris, seemed like there'd be a time or two. You was catching up to him?
Well, nobody else has been able to even see him, so I could stay in the lead lap with him and see him, but we'll just keep working and we'll eventually get there.
Good, strong car, but now, you know, I mean, he had a good, strong car, but we can't say anything against yours. I mean, you stayed right up there with these guys. You had the M2 following you there about the same car length back. I mean, you guys looked like you had them strung out pretty good up through there for the lead.
Well, the street stocks has got way out of hand, motor and, well, body. You can tell by looking at them, but, you know, it is what it is. We'll be back next Saturday night and try it again.
Fantastic. Who would you like to thank tonight, Chris?
Well, all of my crew, Bill, Rex, Travis Fultz for the motors. I mean, I can't thank him.
All right, well, you had a good second place finish. Congratulations tonight.
Thank you.
All right, y'all give him a round of applause. Driving us number 36, Chris Rickett. Well, let's do that real quick.
And I forgot to thank God, and I should have thanked him first. I'm sorry for that, but without him, then none of us would be doing this.
Absolutely right. All right, congratulations. Good finish, Chris. Justin Overton, you had a good-looking car here, brother. You started second, wound up first place. You had pretty good battle on your hands.
Actually, I started 10th.
Oh, did you start 10th? We didn't have you listed as 10th on this page. But anyway, it's never right up there anyway. But anyway, you come up through the pack. You had a good battle up there. Had a good battle up front. Went a little bit of a, you know, mess around over in turn two. Had a couple of those guys go up into the wall, kind of open up the door for you. Tell me about the car.
I loved the track. The car was hooked up tonight, doing pretty good. And I made a few adjustments after hot laps, and it worked out for me.
Now, where are you racing out of?
We usually run 411.
You run 411?
Yes, sir.
Have you ever run up here before?
Never been to Bulls Gap, first time.
What'd you think of the track?
Love the track. I like the long straights and long corners. It's a real nice track.
Well, let me ask the fans up there, what'd y'all think of the classic racing we had here tonight? Did y'all enjoy that? Would y'all like to see these guys come back and do this again? Yeah, I enjoyed the race. I mean, I enjoyed it. Now, all you guys that raced here tonight pretty much run together?
Yeah, the biggest part of us do. There's a few runs Tazewell, and a lot of us run 411, but we've all ran together before.
Fantastic. Who would you like to thank as far as the car goes?
I'd like to thank Zachary Williamson at Animaze Vaporing. He's one of my biggest sponsors. Cutthroat Graphics, Jeremy Mize Excavating, and Jay Overton Truck and myself.
All right, fantastic. Well, congratulations on a good, strong finish here tonight. Grab the checkered flag. Hope you guys come back to Volunteer Speedway.
All right, we sure thank you.
All right, congratulations once again, number 98, Justin Overton. Out here. So we'll start with our third place finisher back here driving this number 7. Y'all give it up, John Stevens. John, congratulations. How'd you like racing here in this thing tonight?
It's fun. It's first time, the second time I've ever been here and first time I've ever raced.
Well, what'd you think of the track? It's first time on this track. What'd you think of it?
I liked it. I hope we get to come back.
That's a good third place finish. Now, you led this thing for a little while out there. Of course, we had a couple of tangles out there, but, you know, these guys give you a good hard run. Tell me about the car.
Yeah, the car is real good. I like to thank the VFW and Red Eye Racing and Justin. He taught me into coming.
Well, he talked you into a good finish here tonight. At least you come in third. You got a good finish here on a good night to race as we celebrate Walter Ball. Appreciate you guys coming out. Good, strong finish. Hope y'all come back and do it again.
Me too. Thank you.
All right, congratulations, John Stevens.